know that once I defeat him, there will be a title shot coming. But what comes first is Adrien Broner. I take him down in a traditional fashion, and then it's all up to him.
No problem.
Hey, how you doing?
It's probably every part. So, I hear you're doing a lot of work for Spring Mountain Youth Camp.
I am. I always like staying very involved with the youth here in the community, and we try to help out in any way possible. We try to give them positive tips of being a positive role model, or showing them how we got to this position. I feel that that's very important, by leading by example, showing them and explaining to them how we made it through. Because some of the kids just make mistakes, and we all make mistakes sometimes. But I want to make sure to let them know that they can continue to progress from the situation that they're in. And it's just by explaining how they can do it, giving them different options and helping them out when they come back down to the city as well.
Do anything different for this upcoming fight?
Yeah, I did. I actually added a nutritionist. I should have done that years ago, but better late than never. And it's actually benefited me very much. I feel stronger. I feel with plenty of energy throughout my training camp. And throughout this training camp, that's the same emotion that I've had, the same energy that I maintained. And it's benefited me a lot. And I feel that we're going to be victorious and we're going to win in a sensational fashion because of that. You have to have people that know their different science, around the sport. I have my boxing trainer, I have a strength and conditioning coach, and now I have a nutritionist. We have a great team behind us, a great promoter, advisor, our Heyman Water Valencia. We have a good team together.
So you're totally a Vegas local, like Vegas royalty. What do you have to say to your fans?
Well, first of all, I want to thank my fans for supporting me throughout the years. And I know that we can.
Hey Jess, can I get you real quick?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. So you started your career with Floyd, and now you're back at Floyd's gym. Does it bring back memories?
It does. I mean, I've been here several times recently, and for that reason, it does bring back memories. I enjoy it here. I had a lot of success. I was very comfortable here, and I'm happy. I'm happy to be back.
I was going to say, who is the underdog in this fight?
I'm not sure. To me, it doesn't really matter. I don't stay updated on that, but the fans are going to see a great fight. I'm looking forward to coming out with the victory.
Got it. What are you expecting from Adrien Broner fight night?
From Adrien Broner, I'm expecting a talented fighter, but a fighter that's limited.
All right. Adrien is known as the problem. Are you the problem solver?
He's definitely going to have a problem when he faces me. That's the issue there, and I'm ready for victory.
Got it. All right. Also on your card, you have Tank versus Cuellar. Break it down.
I'm not very familiar with neither fighter. I do know that Cuellar is a heavy puncher. I think both of them are heavy punchers. I don't know very much about them.
Adrien mentioned he wants Thurman next.
I'll tell you what, that fight anyone? I think is going to be by knockout. Whoever wins in that fight is probably going to be by knockout.
By knockout?
Yeah, Cuellar and
Davis. Yes. And then Adrien mentioned he wants Thurman next. Is there anyone you want next?
He can keep wishing, but he has a big problem against me.
All right, thank you, Jesse.
All right.
Fue un boxeador inestable en cuanto a su vida personal, ¿te da cierta ventaja?
Pues la verdad eso no me interesa a mí. Yo espero el mejor entrenador que se puede presentar el 21 de abril. Nos preparamos para eso, estamos más que listos para salir con la victoria. Ya falta menos de 2 semanas que vamos con todo.
Lo que es el juego de los welters se está moviendo. Turma se lesionó. Parece algo en contra de eso. No quiso aceptar a pelear contigo. Se habla de que Porter pelea el título interino. Se tiene muchas cosas, se están moviendo los welters. ¿Cómo ves el panorama ese?
Pues mira, ya con este Keith Thurman que se lesionó, cosas pasan, pero ya que tiene tanto tiempo sin pelear, yo pienso que alguien más debe de pelear por esos títulos mientras él esté recuperado para poder regresar. que ahora sí tener la oportunidad para recuperar los títulos, pero ya es hora de que otro peleador en el welter pelee por esos títulos de la CMB y AMB, porque tiene mucho tiempo esos títulos en el aire, que nadie los puede defender porque nadie los quiere defender. Si él no lo quiere defender y ahorita se lesionó otra vez, entonces ahora es más tiempo todavía que le tienen que dar para poder pelear, y esos títulos están invencibles ahorita, o sea, no se pueden tocar. Entonces, se me hace justo que otro peleador, sea Dani García, sea Sean Flores, sea yo, como pelear por un título.
¿Qué tanto extrañará a Jessie Vargas a repararse ya el 21 de
abril? Mi padrino, lo extraño ahorita, pero si voy para adelante, yo sé que está conmigo, yo estoy seguro que él está conmigo ahorita, sonriente y al lado mío, ¿no? En el futuro nos miraremos, ahorita no, pero solamente los sueños, aunque no lo crean, de vez en cuando he soñado que me platica y que habla conmigo, pero es parte de la vida, creo que es para adelante.